Often from a vanilla vantage point, the stereotypical projection mentally of what a dominant is very cold, very harsh, yells, very aggressive, domineering, etc. But there are many of us in the lifestyle, myself included, who often prefer a different style of dominance called sensual or soft dominance. For this video, my outline continued to expand into over 3 pages of content. So what we're going to do is break up this discussion over the next 2 weeks. Today we're going to talk about what is soft dominance and the skills required to operate as a soft dominant. And then next week we're going to talk about the benefits of soft dominance, the usefulness of soft dominance with the dom switch woman, and feedback directly from my community as to what their doms do that most effectively inspire their submission. But before we jump into it today, I wanted to do another patron spotlight shout out to my wonderful patron sub cub who brought this lovely necklace to us. Isn't it so absolutely so lovely? I put the link in the description so you can grab it on Amazon. Because everyone has their own line when it comes to what is aggression, soft dominance is a highly subjective term that refers to a mentality and style of dominance that typically involves the following traits. The dominant's focus is on pleasure and connection over pain and power. The dominant does not use tools of violence, aggression, or humiliation. The dominant inspires and coaxes obedience versus commanding or demanding it. The dominant finds power in having no need to be aggressive. Essentially, the dominant's mentality is, I can yell, but I shouldn't have to. The submissive partner is treated with respect and praised rather than degraded or humiliated. And when mild pain is involved, it is intended to complement any pleasurable stimulation versus intended to push the submissive's limits. As an erotica author, I'm very visual with my words, and so how I see soft dominance in my mind as a word picture is soft dominants don't stand above you and intimidate you to cower and kneel for them. Soft dominants sit patiently in their chair, waiting for you to crawl to them. A great visual example of some of these traits comes from one of my favorite kinky movies, Secretary.
Put your elbows on the desk. Bend over, get your face close to the letter, and read it aloud.
Now, Mr. Gray, the original Mr. Gray, by the way, demonstrated soft dominance very, very well here. He invited her into the office. As she was walking past the door, he closed the door behind her, so there's physical distance. He kept his hands to himself, either behind his back or to himself. He didn't approach her physically. He didn't broach any territory. Right? And he gave a very soft but pointed command. He didn't have to yell to get her to bend over that desk. Now, some roles or titles in the lifestyle that often manifest soft dominance include daddy dom. Daddy doms are often very, very soft and nurturing with their littles and their subs. Mommy dom too, all right, often very nurturing. We also have caregivers, you know, caregivers who are more focused on literally providing care versus any sexual dynamic or aspect of it, often very soft in their dominance and very nurturing. And this is not always the case, but I still added it to the list because as a submissive trainer, I know that you don't know what you're doing, right? So we trainers approach your submission from the place of ignorance. We know that you don't know what you're doing and that you are here to be guided. So typically, we are often more, not lenient, but more empathetic and therefore softer in our style or presentation. Now, soft dominance is still dominance, but I believe soft dominance need to have a little bit different or expanded skill set. It's not that you can't do this as a newbie, and it's not that your skills as a master or a sadist or a degrader won't serve you here, but you need to expand your skill set if you want to be a soft dominant, if you want to operate within this realm of sensual dominance. Because really, it's easy to bark orders and be threatening and physically intimidating and physically overpower someone, right? I mean, hello, that's what rapists do. They see someone that looks sexually appealing, they have a sexual desire, but rather than looking at that person as a valuable human being deserving of respect and autonomy, and taking the time to seduce that person, what do? They take sex, which is a beautiful, beautiful gift of connection and eroticism and pleasure, and they take it and they manipulate it and they use it as a violent tool. So yeah, yelling and aggression and physically overpowering and intimidation, those are relatively easy tools. They're relatively easy to learn. In my opinion, they often don't need to be taught. But with soft dominance, because we're not inspiring submission from the top down, we're inspiring submission from the bottom up in kind of a cradling and support position, our skill set needs to be expanded. I believe soft dominants need to possess at least these five traits: patience, being willing to wait uncomfortably for your desires. Soft doms have to be incredibly patient because, again, we're leading and we're guiding, but we have taken the aggression or violent or intimidation or humiliation element out of it. So really, we have to give our submissive the freedom to kind of navigate at their own pace. Yes, with our guidance and yes, with our pushing, but only to a certain extent. So patience is incredibly vital as a soft dom. Self-control, the ability to choose patience over indulgence. When you want to pounce, you have to still slowly hunt. Mindfulness, being present and able to read your sub's non-verbal cues. Now, mindfulness is important for all of us in general, especially dominants, but even more so for soft doms, because in my experience on the bottom side of a soft dom is there's a lot of energy exchange and there's a lot of looks and there's a lot of nonverbal cues. And so mindfulness, being able to stay present in the moment, not get distracted and really focus on the energy exchange, on the expressions, on the tone of voice, on the words that are being used, on the words that are not being used, etc., that will serve you very well as a soft dom. Insight, knowing your submissive's mental and emotional state and triggers. Because soft dominance has more of a focus on pleasure and connection, soft dominants need to be aware of the triggers that would sever that pleasure and that connection. And speaking as a dominant here, I don't really care sometimes if you don't like what is going on. Actually, most of the time, I don't care. You're here for my pleasure. You're here to serve me. That's my perspective as a dominant, not a soft dominant, as a trainer, as a degrader, okay? That's my perspective. But a soft dominant's focus is very different. Their purpose is to build connection and build and heighten pleasure. So they need to be very, very aware of any triggers that would jolt their submissive out of that pleasurable headspace. And finally, knowledge. Not only of your submissive's limits, but of their points of arousal. Again, the purpose of soft dominance is very different. Pleasure, connection, eroticism, ecstasy. So we gotta know what turns our submissive on, because that's how we bait them and that's how we keep them in subspace. Not by giving them that cold, hard, aggressive energy that overwhelms them and pushes them to their knees, but such a warm, supportive space that they can't help but just fall and rest their heads. For instance, my partner, who I very much consider a soft dom, has no desire to top me with aggression whatsoever. And I never feel like he's trying to control. I feel led, I feel guided, and I feel like I just want to fall underneath him. but never because he demands it or he pushes me to do so. And that is what makes me want to submit. In fact, a great example of this happened just a few days ago. I was working on a project and I was super in dom space about it because I'm in work mode. I was even dressed full dom gear. I was recording, I was doing photos, etc. And I was just in this really intense, aggressive space, but my head was off. You know, have you ever had one of those days where it's just like your head just feels like it's going just so fast, or your thoughts are more jumbled than they normally are? Okay. So I was just having one of those days where my head space was just off. So I was having trouble with this project and it was frustrating me. So I go downstairs to get a drink of water or something, and my partner comes in and he asks me how the project is going. And I'm like, oh, I just suck today, right? And I'm turning around, I kind of just set it over my shoulder, and I turn around and I'm walking away, and from behind me I hear, "Come here." And instantly, and I turn around, when I turn around, he just has his arm out just like this, like, "Come here." And he just has this very subtle look on his face, and with all of that intensity, with all of that aggression, with all of that energy that I was experiencing in full dom gear, I melted. I turned into just a little giddy girl and I just trotted over to him and nestled in his chest. And it was beautiful because it allowed me just the freedom to process all of those emotions, to come down from that highly aggressive, frustrated headspace with his just gentle guidance and care. And it was incredibly effective in multiple senses of the word. So like I said, we are not done talking about soft dominance. Stay tuned, because next week we're discussing three more points: the benefits of soft dominance, the usefulness of soft dominance with a switch woman, and ways that soft dominance can most effectively inspire submission.